Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making slow cooker apple butter. Everyone seems to love apple butter in the fall, and this is an easy way to make it because you don't have to stand over it and stir it or anything like that. It's going to be done in a slow cooker or crock pot. And I've already turned this on to low. We're going to use Granny Smith apples. And for this recipe, you need about 3 pounds, and that turns out to be about 5 of this size. You don't have to use this kind of apple. If you have lots of cooking apples, then you might want to make use of those. It just needs to be a tart apple that is not mealy. It needs to have some substance to it. So the way you prepare them is to peel your apples, and then take the core out and slice them so that you have slices about like this. And you'll end up with about a bowl full. And as you work on them, you want to keep them nice and fresh looking. So if you'll just do your peeling and cutting into a bowl of salted water, and then when you're ready and have everything prepared that you need, you can drain off that water and then you're ready to go. So we're putting this into our slow cooker. Remember, that's 5 apples, about 3 pounds. And they're prepared. And it should fill your slow cooker up to maybe halfway or 3/4 of the way. It depends on the size of slow cooker that you have. So we're going to add some sugar and some spices. Starting with the sugar. Now, I have 2 cups here, and I want to be honest with you, my recipe actually calls for 3 cups of sugar. And Rick and I just like to cut back on sugar, and we don't mind having things a little tart, and we know that we can always add a little sugar at the end if we need to. But I want you to be aware that some people would prefer this with 3 cups of sugar, but I'm just demonstrating it with 2 cups because we have to eat these. Next comes our spices. We have 2 teaspoons of ground cinnamon. And then we have 1 teaspoon of ground nutmeg. Next comes 1/2 teaspoon of ground allspice. And then we have 1/2 teaspoon of ground cloves. And then 1/4 teaspoon, or just a dash of salt, just a little bit. Now, we're going to be stirring this up, but there's one more ingredient, so I'm just going to spread this out a little bit and then pour my liquid in. We have 3/4 cup apple cider. So just pour that over all of your apples and spices and then stir. So here's what your mixture looks like after it has been stirred. And we're just at the starting point of making this apple butter. You want to turn your crock pot on to low. I've already done that. So I'm ready to put the lid on and then take it easy. Actually, we want this to cook until it's thickened and spreadable. So I can't predict exactly how long that is, but it's going to take about 8 hours, or usually what you would do is do this in the evening and let it cook overnight. But I'm starting pretty early in the morning, and I might be able to finish this during the day today. If not, then tomorrow morning I will finish up the video, because it definitely will be done at that point. So cook it on low and just walk off and forget about it, except for the wonderful smell you will have in your house. Our slow cooker apple butter is done. And actually, it got done yesterday, the day I started it. It probably took about 8 hours for it to get to the point where it was nice and thick and of spreading consistency. Well, I didn't want to finish the video at that time, so I just lifted the crock out of here and put it in the refrigerator after it had cooled to room temperature. And then I let it just stay in the refrigerator overnight. And I've plugged it in and put it on keep warm. Actually, I've unplugged it at this point. But this is what you get. I think you can probably see that. And I want to show you how nice and thick it really is. It should look like that. If this looks too watery to you for your purpose, then you can plug it in and put it on high, leave the top off, and this will evaporate a little bit and thicken up. But for me, this is about the way I would like it. So I'm going to put it into a bowl because it's quite a lot here and I need to store it in some fashion. And I'll be using a little bit of it for our breakfast. So here is our slow cooker apple butter. And this is not all of it because there's probably about half a bowl still left in the crock pot. And what I need to do with that is to let it cool down and then put the remainder of this back in with it and refrigerate it, and we can use on it several days. If you want to can these, that is a possibility. You can put them into pint canning jars and then put them in a hot water bath in order to get them sealed properly. And you just have to look at another video, not one of mine. I haven't done that in my videos. But someone out there will have canned anything you can imagine. But I'm just going to serve this for breakfast. So on my plate here, I have a little bit of fruit. And I echoed the taste of apples by putting a few slices of apples and then a few slices of bananas on top of that. And here I have a slice of buttered toast. So we're going to give ourselves a little container here that has apple butter. So over here at our plate, I've got a tasting spoon. I think I'll taste this alone and then I'll put it on my toast and taste it with something. I've let it cool down just a bit. It's still nice and hot. That is so flavorful. And it is tangy. You might recall that I cut back on the sugar from what was in my normal recipe, but I like it like that. All right, what I'm going to do is just spoon some of this out on my toast, which I've already buttered. You can butter your toast or not. You could have biscuits. You could use waffles, whatever you like. What I want to do is give you a taste of the combination of toast or bread of some kind with this apple butter. Mmm. It's really great to have something to tame the flavor because it is very spicy and very intense, but wonderful, actually. I think you can probably imagine what that's like if you have eaten apple butter before, but this is a particularly easy recipe. If you don't mind the little bit of work you have to do to put it in the crock pot, then you just wait and then it will be done either overnight or within 8 hours and you're ready to eat it. Hope you enjoy it.